marks by which the ranches label their products. Each ranch has its own special pattern of numbers or initials, or the brand may be suggested by some useful, everyday object. Here the branding irons are heated, sometimes in an open fire, or perhaps in an old oil drum. Their handles extend from the fire. They are carried to the branding to be stamped onto the top of the calf's thick hide. They are then the property of that ranch and may be used by no other in the same vicinity.
In the fall of the year, when the eager fingers of the early frost paint the aspens in the high country in vivid colors, it's roundup time.
The growing herd moves on along time-traveled routes,
almost suggesting a ghostly symbol of the herds of the old Chisholm Trail,
headed for a familiar corral.
The whole vast west becomes one big dusty roundup.
And you'll soon be back with Mama. A touch of the branding iron, and off you go. You don't want to be a maverick, do you?
During the NBA All-Star Game weekend, Commissioner Larry O'Brien announced that the league would add two new teams in the 1980-81 season. One of those teams would be located in the Lone Star State, in the city of Dallas. A year later at the 1980 NBA All-Star Game, league owners voted to admit the Dallas team into the league. During the initial few months of the franchise, the Dallas Basketballers would be the placeholder name until a local radio station, WBAP, held a Name the Team contest among listeners. After receiving more than 4,600 entries over 3 weeks, the results were turned over to a 5-person committee. The committee narrowed down the choices to the Wranglers, Express, and Mavericks, and presented them to owner Don Carter, who had the ultimate decision. Then, on May 1st, 1980, team officials gathered the media in Reunion Station to announce the name. A blue and green flip chart revealed the chosen name suggested by 41 fans during the contest: the Mavericks. One of those fans, Carla Springer, a freelance writer who won a drawing for season tickets for her participation, said the nickname represents the independent, flamboyant style of the Dallas people. The team's name was also inspired by the 1957-1962 TV Western Maverick, starring James Garner, who was actually a member of the original ownership group. Interestingly, down the road, the University of Texas at Arlington also used the Mavericks nickname, having changed from their Rebels identity in 1971. They objected to sharing the name, so much so that they ended up printing 10,000 bumper stickers with the phrase, "Mavericks, nowhere but UTA," and passing them out all over town. The term Maverick comes from Samuel Maverick, an early Texas rancher who didn't brand his cattle, either due to laziness or in order to claim ownership of wild cattle. Since they were unbranded, other ranchers would come to call them Mavericks. Eventually, the term would be recognized as meaning wild or untamed, and could be used to describe someone as unorthodox or independent-minded. Norm Sanju, the first general manager, said that the team's original colors, green and blue, were chosen because they both represented a North Texas countryside scheme, and because Reunion Arena, already under construction, had blue and green seats. Sanju cleverly mimicked these colors, so it looked like the arena had actually been built for the team. Let's not imagine what the Mavericks would have looked like had the seats been brown and yellow, or anything worse. The original Mavericks logo is a green basketball adorned with the letter M and a cowboy hat next to the team's name in a Western-styled font in blue with a green border. It was developed by Bill Wynn of Stark Design Marketing, Inc. It underwent 77 revisions before it was finally approved by ownership. The italicized M was meant to depict movement, while the hat was a little nod to Don Carter's trademark white cowboy hat. One of Sanju's main points of focus was on not allowing Mavericks to be shortened like the college team did. UTA frequently truncated Mavericks into Mavs, but with Sanju running the professional franchise, he would ensure you only saw the complete Dallas Mavericks during his tenure. The booming echoes of "Let's go Mavs" were very far off. For the inaugural 1980-1981 season, the Mavericks would have traditional home and away uniforms. Debuting against the future hated rival San Antonio Spurs, the team won their first game in their traditional home set. It included a white base with blue-white-green ribbing on the jersey's neckline and armholes, and on the shorts' notch leg holes and waistband. Mavericks was in all caps in a rustic blue font with white and green trim, numbers that matched. The player's name on the back, or NOB, and the cowboy hat logo on the left leg of the shorts. The road set was similar but featured a blue base with green-white-green ribbing and Dallas in the same font but with white coloring and blue and green trim. The word mark was slightly different than the one featured in the logo, being slightly skinnier and taller. These uniforms were produced by Rawlings for the team and were made out of nylon and polyester and had triple-layer tackle twill for the word marks, logo, names, and numbers. Unfortunately, the Mavericks wouldn't see many more wins in these, finishing the season 15-67. Past Mavs who wore these include Tom Lagarde, Brad Davis, and Jim Spanarkle. The next season, with the arrival of Mark Aguirre, Rolando Blackman, and Jay Vincent, the Mavericks switched up their uniform slightly. They would mostly stay the same, but the team opted to switch green for blue on their road sets. With its green base and blue-white-blue ribbing, the Dallas Mavericks had found their most striking identity, one that has fans clamoring for a return some 40 years later. Experiencing Moody Madness and reaching Game 7 of the Western Conference Finals, these are the uniforms the Mavericks would find their early success in, going 418 and 402 from 1981 to 1991. Past Mavs who wore these include those mentioned before, along with Brad Davis, Derek Harper, Dale Ellis, Sam Perkins, Detlef Schrempf, Uwe Blob, James Donaldson, and Roy Tarpley. Things would stay mostly the same for a while, with only the manufacturer and supplier changing from Rawlings to McGregor Sandknit in 1986, and a Champion in 1990. For the 91-92 season, the Mavs updated their identity for the first time in a decade. The Western font had been updated to something more modern, removing the green outline and shrinking the cowboy hat logo slightly. The uniforms also somewhat changed as well. Colors stayed the same, but the script for both the city and team name reflected the change to the logo font, and the numbers were now a traditional athletic block. Details like ribbing on the jersey's neck and arm holes, and the shorts' waistband and leg holes stayed the same, while the team's success continued to trend downward, finishing the season 22-60. Past Mavs who wore these include Rolando Blackman, Derek Harper, Brad Davis, James Donaldson, Terry Davis, and Fat Lever. A year later, the team drafted Jim Jackson and tried to find some luck by returning to the original uniform color scheme with a blue base. The basketball gods must have despised this, as Dallas had its worst season yet, finishing 11-71. Oops. Past Mavs who wore these include Derek Harper, Sean Rooks, and Doug Smith. Dallas drafted Jamal Mashburn and Popeye Jones arrived, and the only changes they demanded were longer shorts and a slight darkening of the blue, giving the Mavericks their seminal look for the 90s, going 231 and 393 from 1993 to 2001. Past Mavs who wore these include Derek Harper, Roy Tarpley, Jim Jackson, Jason Kidd, Sean Bradley, Michael Finley, A.C. Green, Cedric Ceballos, Eduardo Nájera, Steve Nash, and Dirk Nowitzki. In March 1996, Ross Perot Jr. purchased the team from Don Carter and began his own rebranding. NBA creative director since 1990, Tom O'Grady and his team were invited to Perot's Dallas area ranch to establish the overall vision. They decided on a bold horse motif with a dominant turquoise and orange color scheme. After complications due to a resemblance to the Denver Broncos' recently rebranded logo, a final redesign was completed. The colors of this logo were meant to represent the original Mavericks era, navy blue, the Texas skies, sky blue, and the copper gates of Perot's ranch. Ultimately, these plans were shelved after Perot sold the team to current owner, Mark Cuban, a few years later. Meanwhile, Dallas switched to Nike to provide their uniforms, and Dennis Rodman wore number 70 for the Mavericks after Cuban vetoed the requested number 69. Nice. After acquiring the team in January, Cuban hired Matt Fitzgerald to oversee the redesign in April that same year. Breaking from the conventional process, the rebrand was outsourced to a small design firm called Propel Group, run by Darren Weirich. There were a few requirements for the design. No green or cowboy hats, Mavericks couldn't be abbreviated, and most importantly to Cuban, it had to go with jeans. Struggling to incorporate the term Maverick into the identity, Weirich opted to eschew the NBA norm of a cartoonish mascot and logo and focused on making the horse more fierce, powerful, and aggressive. The new logo featured a stylized white horse with an M on its head and a royal blue basketball behind it. Dallas, in a modern font, sits above it in a white half moon with a silver shield at the very back, adorned with the full team name in black on a royal blue shape and a white star right underneath that. Two alternate logos were also made. One was a sharp silver M with black backdrop curved over a blue basketball. The second, more frequently used alternate logo, is a silver basketball intersecting a sharp royal blue M and a black shield behind it all. The new identity and uniforms debuted in October for the 01-02 season, coinciding with the team's move from Reunion Arena to the American Airlines Center. The Mavericks' new uniform sets were drastically different from their previous ones. On their home jersey, Dallas took the place of Mavericks in midnight blue with silver trim across the chest. The numbers on the front were moved from the center to the right and are in royal blue with silver trim. This set had much more details than previous designs, with midnight blue blocks by the armholes, royal blue lines that ran down the shorts, another midnight blue block by the waistband that ran around the back to the front, and a simplified logo on either side of the shorts. On the back, the numbers matched the front. The NOB was midnight blue, and the Mav star in blue with silver trim sat above that. This design also featured Nike's new wishbone collar that the Lakers had debuted in 1999 in royal blue. The road uniforms were similar to the home set, swapping white for midnight blue and the navy for royal blue. Midnight blue was chosen over royal blue because although the logo now featured the color black, the NBA would not allow the Mavericks to have a black uniform. The Dallas script was in white with silver trim. The numbers were silver with a white trim. The NOB was white. The Mav star in white with silver trim above that. This would come to be the Dallas Mavericks' signature look for the first half of the Dirk Nowitzki era. They would experience success, failure, triumph, tribulation, joyous victory, and heartbreaking defeat. All while the set was in use, going 510 and 228 from 2001 to 2010. Past Mavs who wore these include Sean Bradley, Michael Finley, Eduardo Nájera, Steve Nash, Popeye Jones, Avery Johnson, Josh Howard, Eric Dampier, Marquise Daniels, Devin Harris, Jerry Stackhouse, Desigana Diop, JJ Barea, DJ Menga, Devin George, Brandon Bass, Jason Kidd, Rodrigue Lebois, Karan Butler, Brendan Haywood, Sean Marion, Deshaun Stevenson, and Dirk Nowitzki. The team's first attempt at an alternate uniform came about in the 2003-2004 season. Mark Cuban wanted to give the team a slight edge to their look and debuted their metallic silver uniforms against the Los Angeles Lakers in the first game of the season. This set used a silver base with Mavericks and caps, fully spelled out in white with royal blue trim and royal blue numbers with white trim. The base set's shoulder and shorts blocks and lines were used, this time in midnight blue and royal blue respectively. The shorts swapped the horse logo for the Mavs' primary alternate logo. The NOB was white, and a royal blue Mavstar with white trim above that. While a good design in theory and conception, the material unfortunately changed color during the course of the game. The addition of sweat caused the flashy metallic silver to turn into a shiny dark brown. The uniforms looked horrible, especially on TV, and after Cuban saw highlights of the game that night, they were shelved. He remarked in 2013 that they looked like wet garbage bags, and fans agreed. Dallas went on to lose the game against the Lakers, being blown out 109-93. Never once holding a lead. The uniforms were an all-around failure. Before the season started, Dallas played an intra-squad exhibition during a Mavs fan jam in which the Dallas word marks on their home and away uniforms were switched to DFW, with everything else staying the same. The Mavericks' next attempt at an alternate uniform came that next season with the league switch to Reebok. After last season's disaster, Dallas brought in someone they knew could make a hit, P. Diddy. Returning to the green of the past, he designed a retro-looking set that integrated the modern design with the classic color. Using a green base, the jersey features similar lines as the home and road jerseys, but breaks up the shoulder area into white and royal blue sections and midnight blue around the armholes. The V-neck has a midnight blue outline on the collar with a white inverted triangle at the point with a midnight blue star in the middle. A new word mark with the truncated Mavs moniker and a rounded white font and blue trim sits at the center of the chest with the numbers in a new font in white with blue trim right above that on the left chest. On the back was the new number set and the alternate logo replacing the star. The shorts got rid of the block on the waistband area and continued the lines and blue sides, flaring out with the alternate logo on each side. The new uniform was a hit. Dallas fans loved the revival of green and overwhelmingly approved of the set. That same season, Dallas revived their 1980s green road jerseys for the team's 25th anniversary. However, these were not exactly the same as the originals. The lettering more closely resembled the original logo font, but only had blue trim around the white letters. Additionally, the number scheme mistakenly resembled the 1993 to 2001 uniforms and also had the same trim issue. While the Mavericks were getting ref ball during their first trip to the NBA Finals at the end of the 2005-2006 season, a Larry O'Brien trophy patch was added to the right shoulder above Dallas, opposite the NBA logo. The next season, Adidas took over uniform duties for the whole league after acquiring Reebok, and the Mavericks did something that postseason, but I can't remember. For the 08-09 season, the team used the same alternate jersey, but had a second version with the numbers below the new Los Mavs word mark in the same Diddy style. These were for select games during the NBA's Noche Latina promotion. Before the start of the 2009-2010 regular season, the Mavericks replaced their green alternates with a similar-looking set in royal blue, essentially the same as the Diddy design uniforms. These swapped the green with royal blue, and the royal blue with midnight blue. The numbers also changed back to the style of the main set in silver with a white trim. While not as celebrated as the originals, the royal blue looked great on the court, especially when compared to the midnight blue road uniforms that had begun to get stale and really extended the life of the Diddy Alt. These jerseys also had the Noche Latina version as well. Following a frenzied free agency where LeBron did not, Dallas made their first change to their away set since their redesign. Imitating the change to their alternate, they swapped the midnight blue and royal blue around. The Dallas script also went from white to midnight blue with silver trim, like the home jerseys. A simple change all around, but one that instantly refreshed the team's look for the second half of the Dirk Nowitzki era. This would also be the last year that the Mavs would participate in the Noche Latina uniform nights. Interestingly, these were also the only alternate uniforms that they wore during the season, and they actually only did it twice. They must not have needed them, because that postseason, wearing only their home and away uniforms, with an NBA Finals patch replacing the regular logo, the Dallas Mavericks got their revenge on the Miami Heat and won the 2011 NBA Finals, and the franchise's first championship. Overall, the team went 183 and 129 in this exact set. Past Mavs who wore these include J.J. Barea, Roddy Bubois, Caron Butler, Tyson Chandler, Brendan Haywood, Jason Kidd, Sean Marion, DeShawn Stevenson, Jason Terry. Vince Carter. OJ Mayo. Darren Collison. Jose Calderon. Monte Ellis. Devin Harris. And Dirk Nowitzki. To open the lockout-shortened 2011-2012 NBA season and hang their new championship banner, the Mavericks wore their traditional home white uniforms, but the Dallas wordmark now had a gold trim. A Larry O'Brien patch was added opposite the NBA logo, and the NOB also had a gold trim. The team unveiled a new alternate uniform as well. Still based on the Diddy version, these uniforms returned midnight blue to the base and royal blue to the sides. Just like how the road version got flipped the previous season, these are just a flip of the old alts, but with the simplified horse logo replacing the alternate logo above the NOB, and with the numbers now below the word mark, which now had a royal blue outline. This looked even better than before, as it solved the issue of light colors washing out the players. These would last through the 2014-2015 season. For the 2012-2013 season, Adidas introduced new jerseys for each team to coincide with the annual games played Christmas Day. Their first theme was big color. Dallas had a uniform produced, but did not play in them. The jersey was the traditional design of the Mavs unis, but used a silver base replacing all the colors, and outlined the word mark, numbers, NOBs, and the star on the back of the jersey in royal blue. In May 2013, Mark Cuban took to his personal blog to announce an NBA first. Fans would have the chance to design and submit new uniforms for the team. The only guidelines were staying true to the logo and staying close to the current color schemes, while allowing flexibility in terms of incorporating past colors. The opportunity lasted until the end of the month, and Cuban received over 1,000 entries through his blog, Mavs.com, and CrowdSpring. 4 months later in September, Cuban selected 10 finalists from the entries to be voted upon by fans on the team's website for about a month. The selected finalists' uniforms employed a variety of different looks, ranging from imitations of other teams' uniforms, a heavy emphasis on horizontal stripes, a return to green, and the Dallas skyline. Although they did not play that Christmas, during the 2013-2014 season, Adidas produced a special sleeve jersey for the team. This jersey had a white base with a simplified horse logo on the chest in silver and blue, NOB in black, midnight blue numbers with silver trim on the back and left sleeve, and a midnight blue V-neck collar. Next season, the Mavericks traded for Rajon Rondo, and the NBA decided to copy his diva behavior and move their logo from the front of the jerseys to the back collar. So the Mavs simply moved the star from there to the buckle of the shorts and entirely removed it from the alternate. Again, not playing December 25th, Adidas made designs for a Mavericks Christmas jersey. These were essentially the same as the regular home whites, but substituted the word mark for the simplified horse logo, had royal blue numbers with silver trim in the center, the same on the back, removed the Mav star, and had a blue nameplate for the player's first name rather than their last. Dallas would play in their slightly different main set for three seasons, going 125 and 121 in that time. Past Mavs who wore these include J.J. Barea, Tyson Chandler, Monte Ellis, Devin Harris, Dwight Powell, Chandler Parsons, Wesley Matthews, Darren Williams, Harrison Barnes, and Dirk Nowitzki. A mock-up of the winning fan-created uniforms, initially slated to be revealed October 28, 2013, before the start of the next season, was eventually shown during a media event in September 2014. The jersey had been designed by Dallas native Jeff Case. His initial design had three versions: a home, an away, and an alternate jersey, all featuring the Dallas skyline. With the home in white and the road and alternate in midnight blue, the Dallas script sat beneath on a royal blue band in white on the home and away versions, with the numbers in blue with silver trim to the right and the skyline in silver. The collar featured metallic silver and a royal blue striping with a blue inverted triangle at the point with a silver star. The sides had a blue stripe with a silver stripe going down the middle. These extended to the shorts with a diamond on the right leg with the simplified Mavs horse logo in white in it. On the back of the jersey, the numbers were the same, with the name and horse logo in blue on the home and the name and logo in white on the away and alt. The alternate replaced the striping on the collar and sides and the skyline with green, the band with midnight blue, the numbers in white and green trim, and the diamond on the shorts now all green with a black logo. During the unveiling, the physical jersey shown was slightly different from the original concept. The base went from navy to midnight blue, the inverted triangle with star was replaced with a silver Mav star usually found on the back above the NOB, the Dallas script was now black with silver trim, the numbers were now silver with white trim and moved to the center, and most noticeably, the reunion tower was missing from the skyline. Cuban confirmed on Twitter afterwards that the iconic 50-story tower would be on the official jerseys. The team debuted the Skyline uniforms during a game in November 2015. Although the initial contest details stated the design would be used to redo the team's uniforms for the 2015-2016 season, it was confirmed that it would only be an alternate jersey. The final version of it replaced the collar design with blue piping along the wishbone collar and had the horse logo on the left leg, the Mavericks wordmark running down the right leg, and had a silver Mav star with white trim in a royal blue box in the middle of the waistband. The logo on the back had been replaced with the NBA logo, and the collar now had the Larry O'Brien patch for the team's lone championship. Christmas 2015 rolled around, bringing with it another unused Mavericks uniform. These again were very similar to the regular home set. The white color was replaced with an off-white looking cream. Dallas was replaced with a festive Mav script in midnight blue, new numbers on the front and back, and the NOB also in midnight blue. The NBA logo was replaced with a red letter stamp style patch with the NBA logo on it. That same season, the Mavericks revived the 1980s green unis again, repeating the same mistake made a decade before. Will they ever learn? The final Christmas jersey the Mavs did not wear was released for the 2016-2017 season. This was basically the same as the previous years, but had a royal blue base and replaced all the other colors with white.
young Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna sh-.
After Dallas drafted Dennis Smith Jr. and Adidas decided not to renew their contract with the NBA, Nike took back the apparel contract with new jerseys and shorts coming for the 2017-2018 season and decided to do away with the home and away uniform designations and introduce their new terminology. Association for home games, icon for away games, an alternate set called Statement Edition inspired by the athlete's mindset, and another alternate set called City Edition inspired by the team's community. The Mavericks home and away became the association and icon uniforms respectively, while the Skyline alternate became the statement set. Due to the new template, the designs for the main jerseys only had to be updated slightly. The blocks near the armholes changed shapes, and the logos on the shorts became smaller. The Skyline set only had to be tweaked slightly. So far, Dallas has tanked to 100-139 since donning the altered uniforms, but managed to pick up a couple players who have helped turn that around. Past Mavs who wore these include J.J. Barea, Harrison Barnes, Devin Harris, Wesley Matthews, Dirk Nowitzki, Dwight Powell, Dennis Smith Jr., Maxi Kleber, DeAndre Jordan, Luka Doncic, and Kristaps Porzingis. Veteran equipment manager Al Whitley was the point man for the team's first city set. The team went with a black base with a gray V-neck and armholes, and neon, action green, and blue piping that zigzagged down from the shoulders to the sides of the jersey and down the legs of the shorts. Inspired by the neon glow of Dallas at night, these uniforms featured a new abbreviated DAL script in royal blue with action green trim on the chest with matching numbers. The NOB is all action green, and the shorts have Mavs in all caps in black with blue trim on the right leg, and the Simple Horse logo in black with blue detailing on the left leg. The waistband included the Mav star in blue, with action green trim in a black box. The phrase, "Only in Dallas," appears above the Nike tag in royal blue. Getting to finally use black as a base pleased some, but the uninspired abbreviation and numbers were rejected. And while fans were keen to see green again, the neon was the final nail in this uniform's coffin. For the 2018-2019 season, Al Whitley again headed the design team for the city uniforms and revisited the gray from the garbage can jerseys. These make use of a gray base with light blue and royal blue piping along the collar and sides. The word mark has been replaced with the Simple Horse logo in gray, royal blue, and light blue. Using the same style from the previous year, the numbers were light blue on both the front and the back with a matching NOB. The shorts continue the piping down the side and bottom with DAL in light blue on the left leg. A royal blue waistband with the Dallas Skyline graphic in royal blue and light blue in a gray box finishes out the shorts. The phrase "True Maverick" appears above the Nike tag in light blue. By far the laziest design for a Mavs jersey, fans and local media outlets rightfully criticized the uniforms as boring and essentially corporatized. Especially when comparing to other team sets, these city uniforms were seen as wholly unrepresentative of Dallas and truly unpopular. I feel it. The 2019-2020 season brought two new uniforms to Dallas. First, Dallas dropped the Skyline and Blue Band, returning the full team name to a jersey for the first time in 16 years. The word mark, numbers, and NOB were all in white, and the text on the shorts was removed for matching logos on each leg. Also gone was the royal blue box. While not flashy in the slightest, these uniforms look clean and truly professional on the court. They may not have excited Mavs fans who missed the Skyline, but they were decent enough to be brought back for the next season. For their city uniforms that season, the Mavs employed Dallas native and creative chief officer of Already Design Co., Tex Moden. He employed a gradient that started light blue at the shoulders, royal blue near the center, and midnight blue on the bottom of the jersey and all of the shorts. The zigzag piping returned in a slightly different style with thin light blue lines and thick action green lines that also outlined the V-neck collar and armholes. The numbering returned to the traditional style, but used white numbers and action green trim on the front and back. And the NOB only in white. Inspired by nearby Deep Ellum and the art found there, the jerseys used a new 1990s graffiti-inspired wordmark to evoke the neighborhood in white with a midnight blue drop shadow and action green trim. The shorts continue the piping and have the simple horse logo outlined in action green on the right leg, DAL, in a similar style to the wordmark on the left leg, and white Mav star with royal blue trim on the waistband. By far the most divisive of their uniforms, fans were split on if these looked good or were a train wreck. They were criticized as being too cartoonish, an amalgamation of everything garish from the 90s. Some, however, appreciated the out-of-box design, enjoying the blue gradient and aesthetic. For the resumption of the season in the Orlando Bubble Games, teams had the opportunity to put messages on the back of their jerseys, replacing their names. The Mavericks chose to put the word equality on all their jerseys, with the word being translated to the native languages of a few players. For Luka Doncic in Slovenian, and Naka Provnost, Gleichberechtigung for Maxi Kleber in German, for JJ Barea in Spanish, Igledad, and for Kristaps Porzingis in Latvian, Vien Leziba. Following the first 4 days of the restart, player names would be returned to the jersey, but now under the number to allow the messages to remain. I feel it fade. Past the 2019-2020 season, the Mavericks plan to bring back the statement jersey from the previous season. They will also be wearing the 1980s green uniforms once more to celebrate the team's 40th anniversary. Thankfully, the incorrect numbering is not returning, as images of the jerseys leaked online October 2020. As far as rebrands go, fans have been clamoring for years for a change. With Dirk Nowitzki gone and Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis leading the team, new uniforms will eventually be needed to distinguish this new era of Dallas basketball. While fans harp for a return to the old logos and colors, completely reverting is very unlikely. Based on past comments and internal data, Mark Cuban is seemingly against featuring green and other past elements, wanting to look forward, not backward. While fans across Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, and elsewhere on the internet have been vehemently expressing their desires for years, even producing countless fan designs, the next uniform sets will most likely fall in the middle between their outdated current look and their outdated retro look. Perhaps the team will listen and create something that can please both MFFLs and Cuban. One thing is almost certain, though. Don't expect the return of the cowboy hat.
Oh my God! Oh! Shut it down! Let's go home!
It's a wrap, Doug!
Man, that is a wrap.